Chief Dr. Sanjay Gupta. An interesting point of context, Doc. From 2 months ago when they stopped the briefings to now, we've had like 1.5 million cases. What have we seen in that time? Give us a little comparable.
It's hard to believe, Chris. I mean, it's just hard to believe all the things that we learned, all the things that we were starting to sort of figure out, and we completely sort of abandoned those things. If you put up the chart, which I know you showed, April 27th, I believe, almost exactly 2 months ago, you see what has happened here. The numbers are not only going up, they're at the highest levels they've been throughout this pandemic. It's as if, Chris, you know, you have a patient in front of you who's bleeding out, and you put a little bit of pressure on the wound, and then you got bored and took the pressure off and kind of forgot about the patient, and the patient is starting to bleed again. At no point did we actually start to take care of the underlying problem here. So there's all this talk about, hey, you know, the numbers are going up here a little bit. They're not going up here, so here's a bright spot. None of that matters at this point, Chris. You know why? Because we're not doing the things we need to do to address the fundamental problem. There is a virus. It is circulating. It is contagious. It is causing the problems that we see. And people will say, well, how come it's not causing as big a problem over here? I don't know. It doesn't matter. The virus hasn't changed. So if you're not doing something to solve the problem over here, eventually you're going to have a problem. You remember they were, you know, Governor DeSantis went up to Washington, spent time in the Oval Office, talking about the fact that Florida, you know, they escaped it. They dodged the bullet. How long ago was that? A few weeks ago?
Yeah.
A couple months? I can't even... 6 weeks, whatever it was. And now we see what's happening in Florida. My parents live in Florida. You know, 80 to 90% in some places of the ICU beds are full right now. See what these numbers are on Monday, 3 days from now. See what happens. The numbers are going to be much higher.
Actually, you won't know.
We're going to have...
You won't know, Sanjay.
We won't even
know. Why? Because they're fighting in Florida, the health department, with the governor, because he doesn't want them to report how many beds are filled. He just wants to deal with patients. Now, help us understand something. Why would he want to draw that distinction? How does that help him?
I don't know anymore, Chris. I've been trying to figure out and try, and I find what I end up doing is trying to justify some of these things. There is no rational explanation for this. The fact of the matter is that the virus is causing significant amounts of illness. If it were just testing that were leading to an increased number of people being infected, you wouldn't have the significant surge in hospitalizations. That's fundamental, right? I was talking to my 12-year-old today about that. She got it right away. She fundamentally understood it. I think people get that, right? This isn't just about the testing. We are going to run into a situation. I remember you and I talking when this was happening in northern Italy, and I had friends over there, and they were saying they would call the hospital. They would call, and they would say, hey, you know, my husband, my wife is having difficulty breathing. They're developing shortness of breath. I'm worried. I need to get them to the hospital. And the hospital would say, we can't send an ambulance. We have no beds in the hospital right now. Can you imagine that, Chris? I mean, I don't know what gets through at this point. We've got to stop the bleeding here. And then we got to take care of the fundamental problem. It is still within our power. I think if it's not the policies in these places, it's got to be the people. Because this is the time to rise to the occasion and actually do some fundamental things that frankly aren't that hard. This virus isn't that hardy. It doesn't like to actually live outside and can't jump that far. If you wear a mask, you keep some distance, you can actually start to get control of this thing. They've done it in countries around the world, so we have real-time data and examples of success stories. That we're not making this up. It can be done, and I'm worried, Chris. You haven't heard me talk like this, but I'm concerned right now because it feels like we've given up at this point.
Well, people get fatigue, especially when the leaders at the top are telling them, take it easy. Look, that's what we saw in Florida. We had those young women from Jacksonville. The governor saying, you know, don't worry about the mask. You can go out. They go out to a bar. All 16 of them get sick. Now they feel terribly about it. We just checked in with them. They're getting better now. But they wanted to come on national television. You know, it's an embarrassing thing to come on about, but they wanted to because they don't want people to be like them. The urgency of regular people is going to have to replace the urgency from the leadership because you're not seeing it in a lot of places.
Yeah, and I think that may be the bright spot here, maybe, because I do talk to a lot of people. I'm on the phone all the time with people all over the country, and I think people do fundamentally understand this. I hope that most people realize that if they wear a mask, we could save tens of thousands of lives. Tens of thousands of lives could be saved by the simple act that you did, just putting on that mask.
It's incredible how that detail keeps floating past It's just unobserved by so many in politics. Yeah, thousands could be saved. Maybe, maybe not. It's just an estimate. Let me ask you, what are you hearing from inside the task force?
You know, there seems to be a little bit of concern and maybe even a little bit of friction within the task force. The testing has been an issue all along, right? We know that in the beginning, the CDC came up with this test. It wasn't a good test. The control part of the test didn't work well, so you couldn't get accurate results. That's been well documented. Here we are, end of June. Why don't we have the more widespread available testing? And I'm not talking about, hey, we're doing 500,000 tests now. I'm talking about, Chris, you want to go do something, you want to go do something with your family, could you get tested? Could you get a reliable result and know that you're negative? You're a different story because you've obviously had it and you have the antibodies now. But I'm talking for the average person. They still don't know how to make decisions about their life, right? 2 months ago, Ambassador Burke said, we need a breakthrough in testing so that people can actually return to some sort of normalcy, get back to work, take a road trip with their family, whatever, all these things that you want to do in the summer. Right now, people are confused. Can I? Can't I? What's the risk? Is that person have the virus? I don't know. Do I have the virus? I don't know. How are we so many months into this with all the resources that should have been tossed at this problem? How do we still not figure out how to do testing in a way that is meaningful to people?
There's still a freaky disconnect. Because I'm sure you're getting it all the time as well, much more than I am. But I'm telling you, on an other, not daily anymore, every other day basis, someone says to me, hey, you know, do you know I can get tested? Hey, do you know I can get an antibody test? Or, you know, I really want to see if my kids had it. Or, you know, I had this really bad thing last year during the holidays, and I wonder if I have any antibody. And they call their doctors and they'll go, gotta go wait, we don't have them. You can go to this drive-in testing center if you want. You gotta wait 5-6 days. Maybe they forget about you and you don't get your results. And people wonder why America is still getting so beat up by something that's been moving from country to country everywhere else in the world. And we're still stuck in the suck.
That's the friction right there, I think. People are still, even within the task force, sort of looking at the CDC and saying, hey, you know, what gives here? Why don't we have better testing? Why haven't we really addressed this in a way that's meaningful to people? And Chris, I mean, you went through this. I mean, you had to get tested. By the way, how are you?
I'm still going
through. How are you feeling now?
I can't wait for your documentary a year and a half from now, Lord willing, I'm alive, where you say, and it turns out that there are all these residual problems with this in the lungs. And people had this kind of olfactory issue. And people had brain fog for many months. And we had to do peptide treatment. Because I'm telling you, I hear from people all over this country. What a blessing the virus has been for me on that level. The kinds of connections I have with people. You know, nothing bonds you through, you know, like illness and pain, right? Where they're still feeling things. Guys are like, oh, or women, you know, I'm a marathon runner. I still can't get my mileage up. 3 months later.
Right.
Cases like mine, not the worst, not ventilators and stuff like that. But I'm telling you, there's so much to learn, and yet we're ignoring what we already know, Doc.
I don't think we have the luxury of even thinking about that right now. I feel for you, Chris. But, you know, we measure things right now in people who've lived and people who've died. We haven't even had the luxury to really look at recovery and trying to improve the lives of people after this disease because we're just still trying to catch up. We're behind the curve here. I hope we catch up. But, you know, I'm worried. I hope you continue to improve, Chris, but I'm worried about the country overall in terms of not taking this seriously enough. Because if we get too far behind the curve, this goes from something that's an unmitigated disaster to something that becomes an uncontrollable disaster. And I don't want that. Nobody wants that.